Well, right before we do, Psalms 86, the Bible said in verses 7, he said, I will call upon the Lord in the day of trouble. Look at your neighbor and say, that's probably a good time to call on God.
That's probably a good time to call on God.
You need to call on him in trouble, call on somebody, or have a nervous breakdown. But I choose faith in God. I'm going to call on him. Amen. It's your choice.
That's it.
Amen.
That's
right. And he said, he will answer. Man, what a promise.
Amen.
Psalms 86 and 7. Call on me in the day of trouble, and I will answer you.
Yes. Amen.
Verses 10 of Psalms 86, the Bible says, for the Lord is great and doeth wondrous things. Come on, somebody.
Amen.
Somebody shout, he's great.
He's great.
And he doeth wondrous things. Praise God. In other words, that's the answer.
Yeah.
He called on the Lord in a day of trouble, and God answered. This great God, come on, Jesus. When he answers, somebody shout, he does wondrous things.
He does
miracles. Jesus is no great physician. Physicians practice medicine. He's a healer. He performs miracles. Come on, somebody. When a man steps back and folds their arm and does their head like this, there's nothing else we can do. Somebody shout, that's when Jesus really likes to heal. Matter of fact, sometimes he waits. Come on, somebody, until they've been going to God. Man can't do nothing about it or with it. And then he likes to move. Job 37 and 7 says it this way. When man's hands are sealed, then I'll make all men to know my work.
Amen.
Sometimes God allows our hands to get sealed.
Come on.
Sealed hands are exhausted hands.
Yeah. Amen.
There's nothing there. You did all you know to do. God says when man's hands are sealed, then. Somebody say then.
Yeah.
He's a then God.
Yeah.
Then I make all men to know my work. Maybe your problems got worse because God wants to do something in your life you didn't know he could do.
Come on,
Al. Come on.
He let Lazarus die.
Yes, he did.
Because God is addicted to showing himself.
Come on,
Al. He loves it. He loves to show parts of him you've never seen.
Come on.
But until you've seen often a struggle or a problem you've never seen, you probably haven't seen the level of God yet, amen, that he's wanting to exhibit before you.
Come on.
See, Lazarus, when he died, Martha and Mary, they cried. Come on, somebody.
Come on.
And in those days, they had hired mourners. That means they had a group of people. How'd you like to do that? What's your occupation? I cry for a living. There's a bunch of them working for free on the streets of America right now. Before I get through, I'll tell you what that is. But later on, hallelujah. But in this day in John 11, they were women and they were men sitting there. And even in Jesus's, when he walked into Jairus' house, remember that? And he raised Jairus' daughter from the dead. The first thing he did was had to get the mourners to stop crying. They started laughing him to scorn. That's one step toward victory. They stopped whining and started laughing. But the reason they started laughing is because he said the girl ain't dead. She just sleeping home. See, when you the prince of life and you lay your life down and take it up again, death ain't no big deal to you. That's why you borrow your tomb and you don't buy it because you ain't going to need it for 3 days. So Jesus walked into Jairus' house in Luke 8 and said, the girl's not dead, she's just sleeping. All the hired mourners went from to,
boy, he's tripping, ain't
he? Hallelujah. Amen. So when Lazarus died and come on now, and he gets there, everybody's crying.
Come on. Yeah.
Everybody's whining. Martha runs out to meet Jesus, and when she runs out to meet him, glory to God, all the hired mourners. The professional whiners.
Yeah.
They make a living whining.
Yeah.
They run behind, hallelujah, and are behind her, Martha. Jesus heard Martha say, Lord, if you'd have been here, our brother would have died. That meant she had a revelation of Jesus as healer. She believed he could heal.
Amen.
But she had never seen him raise nobody from the dead. Sometimes God will let our struggles, he'll let it even look like it's completely dead. There's no way to revive it. Come on, somebody. It'll look so dead, it'll look like, my God, there ain't nothing else you can do. Your hand, so to speak, as Job 37 says, get sealed. Man can't do nothing else with it, but then God says, I'll make all men to know my work. Again, that's Job 37, verses 7. Sometimes God lets our problem increase, get worse, so he can show a side of him you've never seen. They'd have never known him as a dead raiser if he hadn't let the sick die.
Come on. That's right.
Somebody shouted, he did it on purpose. Because in John chapter 11, the Bible said in verse 15, Jesus said to his disciples, he said, to this intent, somebody shouted, it's his divine intention. To this intent, amen, and glory to God, have permitted this, that you might have faith. In other words, Jesus said, your faith is my object. I want you to know what it means to really believe me. So I'm going to let Lazarus, who's sick, go ahead and die, because I want you to understand and it be revealed that not only am I a prophet, not only can I heal a sick body, hallelujah, but I'm the Lord of glory. I'm the Messiah. I'm the anointed one. I'm God manifested in the flesh. Hallelujah. And I have power over death and hell. And if I want somebody to come back alive, all I got to do is say one word, come forth. So he let their problem get worse. And Jesus concluded in this whole story, after he rolled the stone away, Lazarus come walking out, and he told him to take the grave clothes off of it. Hallelujah. The Bible said in verse 40 of John 11, amen, he said, did not I say unto you, if you would believe, you'd see the glory of God?
Amen.
Wow. Somebody shout, if you only believe, you can witness his glory. You can witness his wonders. So he says, call on me in a day of trouble.
Amen.
And I'll answer you. Psalms 86, 7. Why? Because verse 10, he says, for thou art a great God, and you doeth wondrous things. And you, Psalms 86, 10 concludes, and you are God alone. Somebody shout, God by himself. But he would like you to join in with him.
Amen.
He'd like to show you. Hallelujah. Somebody shout, he would like to show himself. Somebody shout, he's still in the show business. Jesus is still in the show business. And I ain't talking about HBO, which I refer to as hell box office. But hallelujah. Come on, somebody. He's still in the show business. Hallelujah. And if you call on him in a time of trouble and believe, somebody shout, you'll see new things.